Hi, I'm Benoit Richaud. I'm an Olympic figure skating choreographer. I remember watching the French couple, Anissina Bezerra, who won the Olympic game. And after that moment, I said to my mother, I want to start ice dance. And I was doing single skating, I was doing jump, I was not very successful. And I didn't even know the discipline ice dance, to be honest. And because of that moment, I realized that that's what I wanted to do. I started to coach ice dance. And very quick, some people started to ask me choreography. And I didn't even know if I was able to do it, but I started to do choreography with not even national skater. And then slowly from regional skater, I started to do national, and then after international skater. Making choreography in figure skating, it's doing a choreography for someone. First of all, there is a person. So the job of choreographer is really to find out who is your skater, and depending the phase of their career, you know, it's knowing what to do with them. That was 2018, and a beautiful memory, the last one was with Kaori Sakamoto, because I worked with her for many years, and I choreographed her program short and free at the last Olympic game, and of course she got a medal, so that was like very emotional. I started to work with Kaori, I think she was 16 years old. So I think you could see her progress from the first Olympic game to the second one. So I did a full Olympic cycle from one to the other one. And I think you could really see in that 4 years a total different transformation, you know. And I'm very glad to see that she still has it, you know, it's stayed, you know, even if right now we do not work together. It still developed. I had the same with Brady Tannell, you know, from USA. I also think with Adam, now it's going to be 4 years we work together. If you look back about the way we were skating when we started and now, you can see that he improved in all different aspects of figure skating, the same with Nina Pinzaron. So I think it's also very important, you know, to have the ability to work with them long term. That's why I try to explain the one shot is might be interesting because maybe they want to have one choreographer for a certain style, or but I think, you know, the best is to have time. Most of my work is based on my feeling for the skater, and I'm trying to really find, you know, what is the best for them. It's very hard to put word into my work because I feel like the way I express myself is by movement. I explain many times to my skater that if I could really explain everything, then I will be a writer and I will be not a choreographer. But I will say that I find the way, I find their way by skating with them and by making them doing movement. So nothing is very precise at first. And then everything start to come, you know, with like the process with time. But at the beginning, I really like to work without any idea, you know. So sometimes, of course, we have a precise idea. Sometimes we really know what we want to do. We really know where we want to go. And we really do something very strategic. And sometimes there is also this beautiful place where we don't know anything. My musician and my costume designer are working with me very closely. You know, I have someone that I work with for many, many years now, and it's impossible to separate their work to my work. So my musician and my costume designer, we really work as a team. And I actually now cannot work without them.
I'm Cedric Tour. I'm a figure skating coach. I'm working with Adam Thierry-Mfa, and I'm working also with Benoit Richaud for the music editing, arrangement or composition. I was a figure skater, I'm a musician, and I think this is a good mix to propose the best service for the music in the figure skating world. Because I understand what a skater need to propose something special. There is a 10% of skater can propose something, but the most of time, it's Benoit and me. We talk a lot about music, about skater, and we find idea. Young skater, we have to find a solution to build a style, to build a character for this skater. Because when they are young, and sometimes they don't know what they have to do on ice. And we have to find ID for the skater. I like be in the clouds, dream. And when I listen music, I imagine a story. We listen a lot of music. And every day I find new music. And in first, I want to propose this new idea, this new music. And after, sometimes we do step back for famous music. I did one time for Daniel Grassel in 2021. I composed an original piece for him, The Joker. You can hear on YouTube. I decided to compose a new version of the story of this character. I did a lot of program, and every time when I watch the competition, I'm scared of maybe the quality of my edit not good, the transition is not good, because when I arrange your music, I listen a lot of time, and for me it's okay, because after maybe 100 time, it's okay for my ear, but I'm not sure. Every time I ask a question to myself, I'm not scared to propose a lot of music on one program, because with this you can propose many intention, many emotion. It's like short film. There is a soft moment, and after you can go to a romantic moment, and after a really powerful. It's like when you draw something on the paper, you do a draft with a pen, and when you are sure after, you add a color. For me, the costume is the final color of the project. You have to love the music with a capital M. Because if you don't like music, you cannot imagine something when you do arrangement or edit. You have to do this with passion.